thank you all for joining me this evening. My name is Alex Berger, and this is The Art of Wayfaring. Now, a lot of you are probably wondering, what exactly is wayfaring? Well, wayfaring is a type of travel. It's to journey, to walk, to wander. And it's my favorite type of travel. I prefer to do hosteling and backpacking. Hosteling and backpacking, it's not like the movie with daggers and violence. In fact, and backpacking isn't scaling tall mountains. It's just carrying a backpack and wandering between hostels. I like it because it's social. It's an incredible opportunity to meet people, to get outside my comfort zone, and to expand myself. Now, we commonly assume that we can't take that magical trip because we can't find somebody to take it with us. That's not true at all. In fact, solo travel is social travel. It's not lonely travel. You're far more inclined to meet people, to reach out, to branch out, to push yourself, to be more approachable when you're traveling on your own. And that's a difficult fact to adjust to, but it's a wonderful fact once you open up to it and you're used to it and you start to believe in it. Now, the following image was taken Christmas Day while I was in Spain, of all places, traveling on my own. You would think that that would be a horrible place and a horrible time to be solo and alone. It doesn't look like I was alone. In fact, it was incredible. We all had a potluck, had delightful food, incredible people. And that kind of gets to the point of it all. It's important that you just pause, enjoy, embrace the moment. And that was one of the beautiful things. That same day, Christmas Day, we sat on the beach, we drank champagne, we played music, and we told stories. All strangers, and then all friends. Life's greatest adventures are seldom expected. And that's a lesson that we spend our entire lives trying to figure out and trying to drive home. The best stories are the things that don't go right. The little disasters, the mistakes, when we say oops, or we get lost. And that's the beautiful thing of it. When you're traveling, you're bound to get lost. And if you're doing a really good job, you're probably going to be getting lost often. So I've got two stories that I kind of want to share with you, just kind of outlining two adventures I had and two incredible life lessons I learned. Welcome to Berlin. I had just gotten in from Amsterdam in the Netherlands, starting a solo trip. I'd been in Scotland and England before that, where I've heard it rumored they speak English. I got in, I didn't have a guidebook, I didn't speak a lick of German, I didn't have a hotel or a hostel reservation, it was raining, I didn't have a map, it was a mess. So I got in there and then lo and behold, I couldn't find a single person that spoke English. I must have asked 10 people. So I did what any good American would do. I paused, I was starting to really get stressed out, I looked to the left and there was a McDonald's. So I went down, I had a Big Mac, I relaxed a little bit, I took a couple deep breaths, and then I set out. You know what? Through the rain, I found my bus stop, I found my bus, I got on the bus, I got through the bus, I got to the hostel, I got there, I made my reservation, and everything worked out. And I learned a very important life lesson there. It'll all work out if you keep your head, you keep a positive approach, and you push forward. And that's when you're going to learn and experience some of the most incredible things in life. The next story I want to share with you comes from Zagreb, Croatia, a little bit off the beaten map. So I've titled this one, Say Yes. It's not a proposition, but it is a late night invitation. So here I am in Zagreb, the capital of Croatia, and I've booked my hostel, I've booked my bus the following day at a place called Split down on the coast. All the plans are set, I'm squared away, I'm ready to go, the adventure is about to begin, and then we go out, a bunch of people from the hostel. Well, fast forward a little while, it's 1:30 a.m., and a couple people say, look, Alex, we're going to this place called the Waterfalls. I'd never heard of the Waterfalls. I was thinking, oh, small puddles, that'll be great. And I was like, look, that sounds really incredible, really beautiful, I'm sure it's spectacular, but I've got my ticket booked, my bus ticket, I've got my hostel booked, there's no way I can do it. It's not part of the plan, it's not part of the schedule. Well, they said, Alex, it's along the way, all you have to do is get off the bus, stop, enjoy, hop on the bus at the end of the day, and continue along your way. I said, well, all right, I don't know. 3:30 rolls around and they say, Alex, we're leaving at 8:30 in the morning. Are you ready to go? So I finished off my drink and I said, why not? You only live once. And I went for it. Needless to say, it was one of the most incredible, gorgeous, beautiful places I've ever been, and it worked out beautifully. There are thousands of opportunities each month, each week to say yes. And yet we pass them by or we don't even see them. And that's a life lesson that transcends travel. It's something that we all need to be more aware of. So when you're thinking about it, get out there. Remember that you can travel. Don't wait to find somebody. Take that solo trip. It'll be one of the best experiences of your life. Don't be afraid to get lost. It'll all work out as long as you have faith in yourself. Believe in what you're capable of. And above all, take the leap, get your passport, get out there, travel, and experience the world. Thank you all so much.